Right, attempt number two of acrylic pouring. Now, I've gone online, I've had a bit of a peep to the consistency of how paint should be. And the thickness. So at the moment, I'm just mixing the paints to what they advise. Now this is going to be a purple box. In theory, it's going to be a purple box. I haven't got any purple, so I've got to mix it. Which is easy enough, red and blue. You get a nice purple colour. Make sure it's well mixed. Now I've got some red, which I don't need a great deal of. I think that red will be fine. Copper, which is fine, and that dog is going to annoy me when I start this because I've got to use the air dryer. Green, I don't need much green. Splash of yellow, I don't need much yellow. Now, I don't know if I'm going to syringe this on. In fact, I probably will. Well, you leave the arrows alone. So, what we need is four syringes. Now there are other ways of doing this, cheaper ways, and where I'm these were cheap anyway, and they'll probably be better for me for my, I won't say my first attempt, it's my second attempt. The other one's turned out alright. No, it's not bad. I'm not going to complain. So before I do anything, I'm going to get everything sorted and then throw that dog out, because all you're going to hear is barking. So what I need to do is collect these paints into the syringe. Tissue. Right, there's my yellow. I'm going to organise myself a bit better. I need to sort these sheds out a bit better. I'm going to start doing stuff like this, because this is not the right environment for painting. Because it's still dusty in here really. Although I do have a plan. Alright, collect some green. Squirt that back out, not getting as much as I want. you know, plenty of copper in that. And I want some red. I don't need those. Right, so I've got my colours ready. Now my problem is when I hit this, well, he's getting up. So I'm all prepared, or am I not? Not quite. I'm going to have to use, I think, a paintbrush of some description to move the paint around, because the tool I want hasn't turned up. It turned up today between 12:30. That's the consistency they say it should be. Right, pour the paint. So, there goes nothing. I've not got enough paint on here yet, but being the amateur that I am, I'm going to experiment with it. There's quite a lot of paint on there actually, more than I first thought. So you've got to spread it about. Get it all down there on the edges. Make sure you get those corners. Don't worry about making a mess. I've seen all the professionals make a bigger mess. Now, when they're doing, they call it a Dutch pour, I think. They don't. Don't have a turntable. They just do it as I'm doing it now. So I'll try and get it even. And what I didn't do was put a spirit level on it, which they do, to make sure it's level. Obviously when you're pouring paint, you don't want it all going one direction. Mine isn't. I thought I'd get it as even as possible. Okay, that'll do for that. want to put a bit of white on it, but I haven't mixed with any white. So I'm going to see how that comes out. Just how I visualised it. That's why I wanted it. I didn't want a continuous run. And I didn't want too much paint on it either. Right, that's where the fun starts, I think, or it's meant to. The first thing I need to do is blow the purple over the colours. You've got a bit more of that on each side. Let's see if this works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. Now, this is a part I've never done, or am I used to? But I have looked on how they're doing it. They're doing it direct and fanning it out, and you've got to do it in one motion as if it was just natural. Spin it around. Now you shouldn't do what I'm doing now because it's called mudding. Now I'm doing things I shouldn't be doing. Attempt, it's not bad. I've got no complaints. It's not like I'm selling it for £1,000. Probably not putting enough paint on it, because they put loads on, and I mean loads. Absolutely tons of it. It's not doing what I want it to do, but it is an experiment. In fact, it worked better yesterday with the airline. I've got to get used to that air dryer. Let's try more paint on like they do. Just found another setting on the air dryer because there was no destructions with it, as I call them. And the other thing is, I haven't got a torch. I have got a torch. It's probably the wrong torch, but. The air bubbles. I should have to get one of those kitchen burners. Right, what I'm doing is looking around the sides, and there's not enough paint for it to run over to make it like a finished product. Now I've seen how they do it. They normally do it with a finger. I can do it on this side. I can just put the paint on and it will pour around. See, the edges aren't quite right. That one's all right, because by the time I clean that up, it will be like it should be. But these sides aren't. Same as the back. But it's okay, because if you're not happy with something, you can just wait for it to drop, or you can wipe it off. But I shall persevere with it. You know, my first one, you learn by your mistakes. Because you've got to get used to the quantity of paint that you need for a pour. Well, that's the lid of the box.